Hello and welcome back to the right part. Recently I've decided that my unhealthy obsession with the Tumblr needs to come to an end, and that I should build a MOC from scratch. Not based on any licensed theme or property, just something straight out of my imagination. It was meant to be an exercise for me to step out of my comfort zone that is continually revising the Batmobile. So I leapt straight into my other comfort zone of rockwork and natural scenery. Oh, and about building from my imagination? Screw that, I did some extensive Google image searching for swamps. I proudly present to you my Everglades vignette, complete with flora, fauna, and lights. The diorama is split into three sections, the air, the land, and the water. Starting with the air, which surrounds us, penetrates us, and in the darkness, binds us in the land of Mordor. Sorry, wrong script. As you probably have guessed, it is quite impossible to represent air with tiny overpriced plastics. Instead, I built a tree. A big tree. This is my second attempt at tree trimming, the first being a hodgepodge layer of leaves hastily thrown onto a Technic axle. For the second attempt, I might as well make it decent. It still relies on Technic axles to represent the branches, however here they offshoot from the main trunk, creating sub-branches, increasing the realism and detail. Also, the leaves are angled now. I used a one piece to position this palm tree leaf at an unconventional angle. If you blow your eyes a bit, okay, a lot. It does look incredibly realistic. Trust me, you'll just have to close your eyes and imagine it. The stars of any LEGO creation are the animals because they're cute and kawaii's a big thing now. Hiding in the treetops is a chameleon, perfectly camouflaged and also partially obscured by a leaf. But with the cute comes the deadly, as a humongous rattlesnake ready to pounce on its prey, ruining us too. It seems that the snake has bitten off more than can chew, for on his menu is this juicy Floridian, and because he is a Floridian, he is preparing to jump into the water. Not the wisest decision, but one with human smart. Calm down, stud shooters, we're not taking the plunge now. I haven't yet rambled about the coast. It's really basic, only plate-on-plate construction. To spruce the islands up a bit, they are scattered with foliage and a lone flamingo. As we're now on the same level as the water, might as well take a dive at the technique I used for the surface. Back when I acquired a hoard of transgreen bricks from the pick-a-brick war, my intention was always to use them as swamp water, for they are translucent, like real water, and thus gives you a sneak peek at the depth. Some sand-green opaque plates are worked in to represent colonies of algae. Back to the transgreen bricks, they're simply laid on their sides and attached with some brackets. To secure them and also to give the MOC a sleek, clean finish, black borders are included and connected to a pair of headlight bricks. But while the transgreen bricks are one of the most straightforward aspects of the MOC, they are the piece de resistance, for they emit a green ambiance that lights the swamp bottom with a magical glow. I can't believe I said that, too cheesy. This section was a pain to build, not least because of that pesky sidewall. I got the idea for the rock cross section from a MOC I saw online, and I promptly try my best to copy it. My apologies. Caught karma or what goes around comes around, this was probably the worst decision I've ever made in terms of efficient MOC construction. The transition between the harder and the softer bedrock was a pain to build. LEGO soaps have a half plate height offset at the bottom, which meant that I had to include half a dozen half plate height differentials to maintain minimal gap in between the slopes. Does it look nice? Yes. Was it worth all the trouble and hair pulling? Hell no. As I was incredibly uneager to duplicate the wall design on the other side, I tapered off the hill. This is achieved with a collection of slopes and some sideways building for the steep cliff edge on the right. Taking a look at the creatures of the depth, we have a sea lobster crawling through the undergrowth, and a fish who's been gobbled by a penultimate attraction, an alligator perched on the rock outcrop. I love the way the foliage is positioned beneath it as if the alligator has flattened the leaves. Naturally, once we remove the gator, the entire top of the hill falls apart as it looks very flat. But with the alligator on, it's superb if I do say so myself. Finally, the lights, ladies and gentlemen. I'm using LEGO standard twin bulb lights which are compatible with Power Functions 2.0 and are accepted into Technic holes. Twirling the model around, there are two Technic holes at the back. We're going to be using the hole to the left, as it has a transgreen starter attached to the other side, giving the light a green glow. The island with the flamingo hides the other attachment point. The island is easily removable to expose another Technic brick, through which we can feed the bulb. And now, the moment of truth. That's it for this video, folks. I hope you enjoyed it. Next one should be a semi-review analysis of Your Name, which is a fantastic anime film. Yes, I'm thinking about bringing back movie reviews, as I've been seeing quite a lot of great films recently, such as Marriage Story and A Silent Voice, which are both excellent too. Or the next video could just be a quick and dirty set review, I don't know. I haven't yet started planning it. If you like the channel, please consider subscribing, liking, and turning on notifications so you won't miss a single upload, even though I don't upload frequently. Until next time, keep on building.